such a huge operation. You know, I had visited some home brews, you know, women brewing alcohol in their own homes or in smaller locations in Kampala, in very small operations. So I thought I had some familiarity with how this works, but clearly this was a much, much larger scale. You know, it's so interesting. As an alcohol researcher, we very rarely talk about the illegally produced alcohol. And in this part of the world, in Uganda and Kampala, it's very high. And the tricky thing is that nobody really knows how to measure it. From a health point of view, there's a huge concern, not just about the alcohol consumption that follows, but also because, of course, there's no regulations in terms of how this alcohol is made. You know, what is so clear when we visited this community is, you know, what they throw into the production. And so from a toxic level point of view, from a cleanliness point of view, from all these pieces, you know, we don't know what the alcohol is actually like. Luckily, there's not been many reports of methanol poisoning, which is, you know, it can be a consequence of inappropriately distilled alcohol. But in addition, from a public health point of view, the health consequences for the women and men and the children that are exposed to this very hazardous conditions, you know, the fumes in the air, you know, the toxic runoff, the heat, you know, the barrels that are exploding. Anecdotally, the women in the neighborhood or in this community, they talk about barrels blowing up at least once a month. And so there's a huge risk for injuries and all kinds of adverse health consequences. And of course, nobody has even talked about, you know, these young children breathing the alcohol fumes and, you know, all the toxic byproducts that might be in the air and all the from all the burning stoves and the burning in the distillery process. Alcohol serves as a barrier. It's a barrier for development. It holds people back in poverty. It prevents women and young girls from education, gender equality. It fuels violence. It fuels the HIV epidemic. And so to me, unless we really focus more resources on alcohol, we're really not going to tackle many of those other issues successfully.